नमस्ते गाइस, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एडवांस्ड मेट्स इन सॉलिड वर्क्स। सो आई विल टॉक अबाउट देम वन बाय वन। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो क्लिक ऑन मेट्स एंड गो टू द एडवांस्ड मेट्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोफाइल सेंटर। सो व्हाट डज इट डू? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्लिक ऑन द प्रोफाइल सेंटर, सेलेक्ट ए प्रोफाइल दैट इज इन नॉट सर्कुलर and select another part that you want to mate. As you can see, these two are combined with each other, but a question arises, so what's happened basically? Basically, these two parts are combined at the center of each other, okay? So for example, and you can also rotate it. As you can see, when rotate, it rotate at the center of, at the profile center of the axis, and you can increase or decrease the distance as per your requirement. Here you can see, or if you want that this piece go above this profile center, click on the flip dimension. Remember, here the profile is the selected surface and this profile center, it works only at the center of the surface. So these mates are basically moving at with respect to the center of the profile, okay? Now the next one is symmetry. So let's see what does symmetry do in another part. Here you see I have two cylinders, okay, but let's delete some mate, center distance, delete it now. And here you see the front plane, but I want that these two parts are at equal distance from the front plane. I can what I can do is click on mates and give the dimension as per the requirement, but it will gonna increase my time a lot of time. So what I can do is click on mate, go to the advanced mates, click on symmetry. Now select the plane it is asking, so select the front plane because I want symmetry about the front plane. And now select the faces. As you can see, they are both symmetric to each other now, and the distance of both these parts with respect to the front plane is equal now. Click OK. Now if I move this part for increase or decrease the distance from the front plane, as you can see, other part is also moving. It is quite beneficial when you need a symmetry about a certain axis. Now let's see another thing. So first of all, click on new part, select the part, click on the workspace, click on the edit component. Now select the top plane, click on sketch, press Ctrl plus 8 for normal screen to the view. Draw a rectangle as per your requirement and go to the features and extrude it. Click OK. Now exit the edit assembly component. Now here we will learn that how, what is the meaning of width. So for example, before I start, I need to delete the symmetric mate. Okay, now let's learn about width center. So click on the advanced mates, click on width. So width is basically used when we want to fix a part in the center of the two bodies. For example, here I have two cylinders and I want to fix this cylinder in between the two. So first thing, make sure that these two parts are not movable. So right click on it. As you can see, it is a float, so it means it is a fixed part. And right click on it and click on fix, so it is not able to move. And right click on this component and click on float. As you can see, I can able to move this part. So I want that my this box or engine is between the these two tire. I am just giving you example where this mate is practically used in life. So go to the mates, click on advanced mates, click on width. Okay, now select the two face in which you want that your part is at the center. After that, select the part and the two faces of it, and here you can see it is totally in the center. Now, if you do another method, for example, calculating, etc., it will gonna take a lot of time. But by using this method, you will get accurate result very quickly. And if you click here, you will see free dimension of percent. For example, if I click on percent, it is a 50% in the center. I can increase the percentage that how much percent it need to be at the center. For example, it is 53% at the center. Not totally at the center. It is a 53%. So right click on it and see another. And the other is dimension. So basically you give the dimension at what distance you want to make it. Okay. So now let's see another. So click on mate. Go to the advanced mates. Click on linear coupler. Okay. So what does linear coupler do? Is basically when you want that your part moves upward in 1 meter and other part moves in other direction. Okay. So in that scenario we use coupler. For example, select a edge to give it a direction and select another edge to give it a direction as well. So basically this edge is telling that you can go upward and downward, and this edge tells this box that you can also go upward and downward. Now when I click on this box and I move it, as you can see it's moving upward and downward, but here the ratio of moving upward and downwards are same. But if I remove this and type 3 mm, so what will gonna happen if I remove slowly, you can see the other part is moving 3 times of the first part. So this is what a linear coupler do. You can also click on reverse. A question arises, where's the real life application? If you want to see real life application of all these parts, I highly recommend you that you check out the description in the link in which I show you where all these mates are used. Okay, now cancel this. Now click on mate again, but this time I'm going to use a distance mate. A question arises, what is the difference between a standard mate and the advanced distance mate? Don't worry, I'm going to tell you. So first select a face and select another face. So here the distance between the standard mate and the advanced mate is that in standard mate you will get a minimum distance and a maximum distance. For example, I enter a maximum distance of 50 mm. So what it does do, click OK, that I can now move this part 50 mm apart from it and 0 mm to the minimum. So it can, so it will help you when your part need to be stopped from the other part respect. If you want to see the application, here is the application. For example, here I made a kaleidoscope, as you can see, sorry, telescope. As you can see, the part is moving with a certain distance and also just pick up and move it. So it is very useful for making mechanism. I highly recommend you use, because I use these kind of mates used very much in real life. Now let's see the another mate, that is the angle mate. Don't worry, I will teach you about path mate later on. Don't worry about it. In this video I will teach you the path mate. So the next mate is the angle mate. So angle mate basically do, so first we need to select the faces. And before I do that, I need to delete the previous mates. Click on delete. Okay. Click on mate. Now click on advanced mates. And remember, in the standard mate, what does do? It just fix the distance between the two bodies. Okay. So that is the difference between standard mate and advanced mate. In advanced mate, you have two options. For example, minimum and maximum. In standard mate, you have a fixed distance. You can't change it with time or with your mouse. But in advanced mate, you can change the change or move the object with distance as with your mouse within a limits. But in standard mates, you can't do anything. It is just a fixed distance. Now, similarly goes for the angle mate. Now, click on the angle mate. Select a face and select another face. As you can see, they are inclined. Now somebody say, hey, it's look quite bad. So what you can do is click on anti-aligned. Here you can see, or you can also click on flip aligned to play with. It is up to you. Now select the minimum angle as per your requirement. For example, the minimum angle is 0 degree. Okay, and let's see what does it do. So basically, click on here, click on rotate part. As you can see, I can move this part at a distance of 0 to 30 degree. Here I will give you the example of this part. For example, here I create this. This is a basically a interesting project. You can watch this tutorial link in description, because I deeply explain how to use this mate in the tutorial link. Okay, now let's go to the last part, that is the path mate. So click on file. Now let's see the last mate. So click on mate, go to the advanced mates, click on the path mate. Okay, here I want that this ball move along this path. So what I can do is go to the sphere and select the point of the sphere, and after that here you will see it is asking for the path selection, and I select this path. So now click OK. As you can see, I can now move this ball as along this path. So what this is what this path selection do to move the path along the surface. Now if anybody doesn't able to if anybody create a sphere and doesn't able to see this sketch, what you can do is right click on your sketch and click on show. Okay, if I click on hide, it will hide. If I click on show, it will show. And if somebody don't want to show this path, so just right click on it, click on hide. Still the ball going to move along the path. Okay, I hope this video is quite beneficial for you. If you have any doubts and queries, make sure you ask in comments. And all the mates that I have shown, I have also given the tutorial link in the description, so that you can learn while watching those videos. Remember, learning basics and learning from practical application is quite different thing. So I highly recommend you that you watch those videos to understand how to use those mates in real life. I hope you like this video. If you have any doubts and queries, make sure you ask in comments. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Namaste.